Canadian Farm. WeatherScope, and it's sponsored by Healthy Choice Frozen Meals, your green light to eat what you like.
Next on WeatherScope, winter rips the Northeast today as a storm dumps snow, ice, sleet, and heavy rain in the region. Meanwhile, snow and gusty winds plague some parts of the northern plains and upper Midwest. Those stories plus in-depth forecasts and analysis on this edition of WeatherScope.
Well, an early blast of winter to the Northeast has left many areas covered in snow, and the winter precipitation isn't over yet. Good afternoon and welcome to WeatherScope. I'm Declan Cannon. We have a Weather Channel crew in the midst of the wintry mix. We'll check in with them in a moment, but first, we go to Rich Johnson in the Forecast Center for an in-depth look at the situation. Rich?
All right, thank you, Declan. We continue to follow areas like Boston, where it started out as a bit of a mix, then it went over to rain for a while. Now we're back into the mix, and we'll talk more about that. First of all, to New York State, where we've seen some snow in Buffalo, and yeah, the plows were out trying to help out the situation. There was about 7 inches of snow on the ground, and as you might expect with that much snow, there's plenty of packed roadways, and the kids were out there trying to earn a few bucks there, shoveling out some cars. Yeah, that's always a good thing to do. And what we're looking at is winds gusting up to 30 today, so the wind blew around for a while. Temperatures have held in the 20s, so the snow has not really melted very much in Buffalo. Well, speaking of Buffalo in western New York State, eastern New York State, we have Mike Seidel, and it looks like in Albany the snow's picking up. Mike?
It has, Rich, over the past few hours. We've got the big wet flakes, the big batch of moisture rolling on through. You've been showing us on the radar over the past couple of hours, and we have another batch coming through later on this evening. We think most of the heavier snowfall will be over with by midnight, but the roads are really getting slick. Now that the sun has set, what little radiation was getting through the clouds is gone. So as we pan out here to the expressways leaving Albany eastbound out towards the thruway, you can see the roads are snow-covered, and you can see cars just barely moving. Looks like this car down here is moving maybe about 15, maybe 20 miles an hour. So the roads are going to be very slick tonight. One thing we didn't get here was the freezing rain, or at least a real good coating of freezing rain before it snowed. So we're in better shape that way. At least with snow, you can get some traction. Remember, if you have ABS brakes, do not pump them. That's not the way to go with ABS brakes. As far as temperatures go tonight, holding basically steady. It's 25 right now, the wind chill is 8, so it's a pretty nippy night considering typically it should be about 50 in the afternoon in mid-November. About 25 degrees below average today. As far as tomorrow goes, you'll wake up to a sea of white here. Most of the snow should be over with. We have a few leftover flurries. Then tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening, as that clipper system out west moves through, maybe another inch or two of snowfall here in Albany. But tonight, it looks and it feels a lot like Christmas here. Rich?
Okay, thanks, Mike. We'll be checking back throughout the evening for more updates. Easy to say, right? Well, anyhow, joining me now is Jamie Simpson. He's a meteorologist following the situation in the Northeast. And Jamie, what about the big cities for this afternoon, of course, heading into rush hour here? Mm-hmm. What kind of weather can they expect?
Well, the biggest cities, Boston and New York, briefly changing back in Boston to some frozen precipitation. They've mainly been spared the worst stuff, being above freezing, mainly having rain falling. But as we head into the next hour or two, cold air starting to make its way back into those cities. Looks like they could have a pretty nasty evening commute, especially north and west of the two cities.
Yeah, and into Boston especially, mm-hmm. Now temperatures are below freezing.
Right, so even downtown in Boston, they're seeing a little bit of snow and ice pellets again. So could be a nasty evening, especially in Boston.
Okay, here's our storm history. We did have plenty of snow up through central New York State. Now that heavier band will be heading a little bit farther to the east. Where is the heaviest snow going to fall within about the next 6 to 12 hours?
Well, we've seen the snow picking up out in Albany, New York, but it looks like this area of New England will likely see some fairly heavy snow, especially as we head into the evening. We do have more moisture head into that area, more energy coming up from the southwest. And the winds atop Mount Washington, New Hampshire, right here, about 6,000 feet up, sustained at 40 miles an hour out of the east, so a lot of moisture coming in off the Atlantic Ocean.
A lot of moisture, temperatures now into the 20s around Boston, New York City, still at LaGuardia, above freezing, so hopefully the rush hour will be over with before it drops below.
Yes, but New York had been up around 37, 38 degrees, so it's possible some of the New Jersey suburbs up in Sussex County could be pretty close to freezing at the moment.
Okay, still plenty of clouds in the northeast, and we're looking at some upper air disturbances help intensify some of the snow. Show us where that's going to be.
Well, the first one that New England has to worry about now is this one. You can see the enhancement in the clouds right there. That's what made the snow pick up in Albany, New York. But we also have this other one back here in Pennsylvania. That'll continue to head off to the north and east. So a couple of batches of possibly moderate or heavy snow at times this evening as we head up into New Hampshire and Vermont especially.
Okay, all of New England, a lot of the mid-Atlantic under the green here. Show us where the snow is as opposed to some of the rain and freezing rain.
Right, well, everything basically north of the line I'm going to draw is snow. And then right along that line, especially where you see some of these brighter areas on the radar, that's likely sleet, pockets of sleet. And it looks like most of Massachusetts, Connecticut, and Rhode Island, actually this area here, teetering right around the freezing mark down to the 20s, seeing a lot of ice pellets and some freezing rain. But it looks like some of that area may change back to snow as we head through the overnight hours as well.
Okay, we saw all the snow on the ground in Buffalo. How much more are they probably going to see?
Well, probably only another inch or two. As you can see, precipitation out in this area lightening up. And in fact, this is about the back edge of precipitation, but they could get more tomorrow evening, maybe another inch or two.
And here's that southern fringe. We're talking about this here.